Welcome here to More Talk FCB and welcome back here, guys, ahead of Barcelona against Real Betis in the final game before the international break. And in today's video, we are going to be reacting to everything Ronald Koeman said in his pre-match press conference. And I've got to say, very, very interesting stuff. Throughout the conference, he was bombarded with questions on a range of topics, particularly surrounding Lionel Messi. It's all coming up in today's video. Let's get straight to it. And I want to start, first of all, with some words, not from Barcelona, but from the side of Real Betis, and in particular, from the very charismatic, a player that you all know, Joaquin. He's 39 years old, he is still playing his football in La Liga, and he's still playing at a pretty good level at Real Betis. And last week he spoke about his time playing under Ronald Koeman at Valencia way back in 2007, which, as we spoke about when Koeman was appointed here as the Barca coach, that spell at Valencia was one of the most difficult spells of his managerial career. He spent less than 6 months at Mestalla, and quite clearly, Joaquin has not really forgotten about his time under Koeman at Valencia all those years ago. He said before this game, it wasn't the most beautiful experience of my career. It wasn't a pleasant experience. But as I always say, one has to live with everything and what happened at that time. He said, I don't want to talk about this issue because honestly, it hurts me what happened there. I had a bad time. Joaquin, though, did not stop there, because when he was pressed about Koeman's managerial qualities and whether he was surprised that he got the job at Barcelona, he was asked there if he was president in the future of Real Betis, would he consider hiring Koeman as the head coach? He responded, not even as kitman. Strong words and controversial words from Joaquin. Now, of course, Ronald Koeman obviously was asked about those quotes in his press conference today, and I think Koeman kept it much more professional than that. He said, I know these things are of great interest to you, but he said the best thing to do in this instance is to focus on the match and not individual things like this. I don't really want to get into it. He said, if he wants to keep talking, then that's his problem, and he drew a line under it. Koeman not really responding to the words of Joaquin, but of course, Koeman was asked in so much detail about Lionel Messi. And I have to stress that right throughout the press conference, we're not just talking here about one, two, three, four questions. It was pretty much every question, bar a few. It was all about Messi, about the pressing, about the video that was circulating, of course, on social media that we discussed on the channel yesterday. Also, of course, you're talking about his form right now in front of goal. And I think Koeman did handle it quite well. He was batting away those questions. He was shutting them down. He wasn't getting too into it. And by no means was he letting the journalist here criticise Lionel Messi. He said the following words. He said, I'm happy with him. I see him very, very focused every single day. He comes with a great attitude. He said, every player can go through difficult periods where in front of goal, it's a bit more difficult for them or unlucky. He said, but Messi is still playing at a very high level and we shouldn't forget that. And like I say, Koeman was very much pressed on it every time he gave an answer. He was then hit with another question. He said, I don't need to repeat myself here. He said, you can paint a picture of any player that you see walking, talking there about this video that we're seeing. He said, I haven't seen the clip that you're talking about. And he said, I've got no interest in seeing it. He said, if you want to go and make something out of it, then you can do that. But it's of no interest to me. He said, you can make anyone look bad. Again came more and more and more questions. He said, I don't really know. I don't know what you want me to say. He said, you say there that it's the 93rd minute where Messi is walking around. He said, what does that mean? He said, I know there was also pictures of me when I was sitting down on the sidelines when I was looking annoyed. He said, people will focus on anything. He said, we need to focus less on the footage and more on the work we're doing. He said, again, you can make anybody look bad, and I've got no problems in this area. Moving away there, though, from Messi's work rate and the questions there about that particular instance, Koeman was also asked about the rest that Lionel Messi may or may not need. He was asked there, do you speak regularly with Messi about resting him? Do you feel as though maybe he should be taking some time outside of the field and not playing every minute of every game? And Koeman's answer was a little bit surprising. He said, we have all of the information given to us about every player. He said, if somebody is not 100% fit, he said, they won't play. Leo included. But he did say, the schedule right now is very demanding, but if the player is 100%, then I think it's not necessary to give him a rest. So Messi there, to be honest, if he's 100% fit, it seems like he'll play. It seems as though, like the rest, it's not going to come unless he has a problem. That, for me, It is surprising. Of course, though, Koeman was also asked about matters as a collective, in particular their emphasis given by the journalist on Barcelona lying in 12th place in La Liga. Koeman was asked, how do you deal with that? What is the problem right now with that kind of situation? And Koeman said, a club like Barca should always be at the top. He said, I know that as well as anybody. He said, but we don't need to obsess over this issue. He said, the season is long. We need to go match by match. Of course, we need the 3 points here, but we need to be calm. And this is an interesting line here. He said, because even when we win, a lot of things seem to happen at this club. And that's the first time, really, the first sentence where I can actually gauge from Koeman a little bit of frustration. And I don't really think he's talking there about on-the-field situation. I don't really think he's talking there about the performances. I think he's alluding to there things coming away from the field, saying a lot of things seem to happen at this club. He knows it's more than just football. He knows that a lot of baggage comes with Barcelona. And just ahead of this game, maybe a little bit of frustration, it's seeping in. Koeman was also asked, interestingly, about Barcelona's defensive problems, of course, against Dinamo, but he was also asked there, over the past few seasons, do you think that Barcelona have been poor defensively on a regular basis? He said, I wasn't here, so I can't really say. He said, obviously, I have watched the Barcelona matches from before, but I wasn't actually here to gauge how the team were doing. But the team did play in a different formation to what we are now. He said, now we're playing mostly in a 4-2-3-1, but he did say the problem exists in midfield. He said, we're not controlling the opposition well. He said, sometimes they'll have more players in that area than we do, and that's what causes a problem for our defence. And that's interesting there, saying that Barcelona in that midfield, number one, are not controlling, and number two, we can get outnumbered. But wouldn't that suggest then that maybe the best approach wasn't to actually drop a midfielder, to have two in there instead of three? Interesting there from Koeman. He was also asked about the subject of Frankie de Jong and whether or not he is a viable option at centre-back. Obviously, he played there against Dinamo. Will he be there in the future? Koeman said, you could call it a bit of an issue that we have at centre-backs. We're limited because of injuries. He said, Frankie can play at centre-back, and especially in games where we have a lot more of the ball, just like in the last game. He said, but I do see, and this is positive, I do see Frankie more in midfield, of course. And that's good news. Like I said yesterday, it's where we need to see him. Finally, though, we do talk about two players who are very much of interest to us Barcelona fans, Carlos Alenia and Ricky Puig. Koeman was asked there whether they'll have chances in the team. Are we expecting them to get more minutes as the season goes on? He said, I've spoken with Alenia about his future. He said, Ricky as well. He said, they both have the chance to play. He said, I saw Alenia in particular, really enthusiastic in his training. He's always looking to improve in that pivot position. He said, it all depends on the training. If somebody deserves minutes, then I will give them. And we'll just have to wait and see whether Ronald sticks to his word and what players we see tomorrow at the Camp Nou against Real Betis. Let me know your thoughts in the comments down below on everything you've seen and heard from today's press conference. What do you feel there from Koeman's responses to those Messi questions? And of course, as well, let me know your thoughts there on our league position, on our defensive issues, on Alenia and Ricky Puig. Let me know down below, and I will see you later on over on TalkFCB for the match preview. It's coming up, the last game. We have to make it count before the internationals. But until next time, guys, as always, Visca El Barça.